Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Finally, NOP Plus, the beta version is available for NIO NT 2.0 models. But only need to apply to enable this function. Today we have NIO ET5 and the first generation NIO ES6 here as comparison. The noticeable difference is the watchtower design. Actually, it calls a quieter super sensing system. If we compare with the first generation, the autonomous driving hardware has been largely improved. This NT 2.0 model ET5 could achieve more autonomous driving features. So especially in future, for city autonomous driving, that would be very, very interesting. NOP is automated navigation on highway. So what is NOP Plus? What NOP, the Plus, stands for? Let's find out on today's video.
The way we're going to turn it on is by pressing the button here, which is the same as the NT 1.0 models. Then the system will tell you the NOP is activated. And of course, same as the first generation, we will be able to adjust NOP Plus speed and the distance with the front vehicle. The maximum speed of NOP is 130 km/h, but for NT 2.0 cars, you will be able to set up the NOP speed up to 10% more than the speed limits on the road. NT 2.0 models could visualize more surrounding traffic information. If we compare with the first generation models, it is because the NT 2.0 models has much higher autonomous driving hardware and sensing abilities. Nowadays, Autopilot should be smart. Under this scenario, the ET5 knew the low traffic jam ahead from the map, so it would stay on this lane even if it's lower. Then I manually turned on the indicator, but just a while, it automatically merged to the rightmost lane in advance for taking exit later. That's a very smart strategy. However, the NT 1.0 ES6 seems not like that smart. When we are getting close to the main road, it will increase the speed for better way merging to the main road. That's very natural and smooth. In comparison, the NT 1.0 model ES6 is more conservative. During the test, the ET5 was very responsive to overtake low-speed vehicles. As you guys can see from these scenarios, without much time for hesitation, it detects the low-speed vehicles very quickly. I think that's very close to human drivers. But sometimes, it's too sensitive, sometimes overreaction. Check this scenario. Another big improvement is the strategy of entering to the ramp. The ET5 didn't slow down suddenly to match the speed limits on this ramp as the ES6 did before. That's definitely more comfortable and safer, especially if there is a vehicle very close to you at the back. However, drivers are still responsible for their safety at the stage, and should be ready to take over the control immediately when any unpredictable event comes up. The overall experience of NOP is pretty impressive. It's smarter, more efficient, more close to humans' driving behaviors, especially compared to the first generation models. With the development of artificial intelligence and self-driving technology, I do believe our hands will be free from driving and ultimately emancipate the productive forces. Again, the time we did this test was few months ago, so some strategies may have been optimized. The official version of NOP Plus is already available now. If I got a chance, I will definitely share with you guys more about the NOP Plus and the NAD in future videos. Please leave your comment below if you have any thoughts, and don't forget to subscribe our channel, and thanks for watching today's video.